Among the trends and buzzwords of modern diets, you've probably heard the word gluten thrown about. Unlike a lot of those buzzwords, gluten is a real thing. It's a mix of proteins you find in the seeds of grassy plants like wheat, barley, and rye, which means you'll find it in food derived from grains like breakfast cereals, bread, pizza dough, couscous, and bagels. Bagels. The word gluten is Latin for glue, and that's how we use it. It's uniquely sticky and flexible, which helps bind ingredients together, like catching bubbles when dough rises, creating bread. And you'll often find it as an additive in products that aren't grain-based, like sauces, processed meats, and even cosmetics. The reason gluten's getting so much discussion lately is for having adverse health effects. But despite what you may have heard, it's fine and healthy for most people. A small percentage of the population have an autoimmune disorder called celiac disease. For those with it, proteins in gluten react with tissue in the small intestine, causing inflammation. This can lead to nasty problems like diarrhea, nausea, and potentially malnutrition. A more common condition, but less understood, is non-celiac gluten sensitivity. It affects somewhere between 1 and 13% of the population. It leaves people with bloating, abdominal pain, nausea, and other symptoms after consuming gluten. In short, it leads to a bad time in the bathroom. Unlike celiac disease, it's very difficult to diagnose. Usually it's identified by eliminating gluten from the diet and seeing what happens. People with gluten sensitivity have to minimise their gluten intake, and those with celiac disease have to avoid it entirely. That means steering clear of cereals, pasta, pastries, beer, malted milkshakes, Vegemite, and anything containing wheat, rye, triticale, and barley. Some can't even eat oats. It can be a difficult and expensive diet to maintain and hard to keep nutritionally balanced, resulting in other adverse health issues. We saw an opportunity to give some of the missing food back. Using conventional breeding techniques, we developed a variety of barley with ultra-low levels of gluten, below 5 parts per million. This is well below the 20 parts per million level recommended by the World Health Organization for classification as gluten-free. Regular barley has 10,000 times more gluten than our barley. People with gluten sensitivity will soon be able to eat a wider array of delicious food without having to make a mad dash for the loo.